In this video, we are going to discuss another method of corrosion prevention. Earlier, we have discussed about metallic coatings. In today's video, we are going to discuss about non-metallic coatings. Non-metallic coating means the base, that is metal or an alloy, is coated with an organic or an inorganic compound, not with the metal. So therefore, these are referred as non-metallic coatings. Let us discuss in detail about powder coating, which is one of the modern methods nowadays widely used, because it is solvent free technique, does not involve any solvents. Dry powder is used for coating, and the coating is corrosion resistant as well as little bit hard and tough. But if scratched with a metal, then there will be scratches. It can be peeled off. What is powder coating? Powder coating is nothing but coating with either a thermosetting or thermoplastic polymer material on the base, that is on metal or alloy. So how actually the powder is prepared before going for coating? For the better coatings, the particle size, the powder particle size should be around 30 to 50 micrometers. And one more important thing regarding powder coating is, whatever the polymer is used, it should have TG above 40 degrees Celsius, means above room temperature the TG should be there for a polymer. Otherwise, what will happen, it will be in the plastic form below room temperature. And the coating can be of up to 50 micrometer. Before going for coating the powder, it is mixed with ingredients, that is compounds like hardeners, pigments, different coloring agents can be added, different texturing agents can be added. These are nothing but the compounds, extra added compounds along with the polymer. The mixture, the added polymer as well as the ingredient mixture, is then heated in an extruder and then rolled into flat sheet. After that, it is cooled and broken into small chips. These small chips are again converted into fine powder. So this fine powder is actually the final coating powder. Then what type of polymers are usually used? They may be polycarbonates or polyacrylates, polyurethanes, Teflon, widely used for non-stick coatings, polyamides, epoxy polymers, polyesters, and the combination of polyester and epoxy. The base usually is the whiteware, white metals or white alloys that are commonly used, like aluminium, steel, nickel, tin, zinc. Then how the powder is applied? There are three methods of applying the powder on the base. The first one is electrostatic spraying method, and then the fluidized bed method, and lastly the plasma spraying method. These are the three methods, but most commonly used is electrostatic spraying method. It all depends, the method all depends on the type of the article that is to be coated. So in electrostatic spraying method, spraying guns are used, like corona gun or tribo gun. And the gun imparts electric charge, negative charge, to the powder, and then the powder is, dry powder is sprayed on the base, which is grounded. And due to the charges, the powder sticks to the metal surface. And after that, the article is heated to form a film on the metal. The base metal or alloy is cleaned with an alkali to remove the grease, and then by sandblasting, the surface is made rough to obtain stronger coatings, or else we can also use pickling with acids. So before going for coating, the surface should be clean and rough. Then the powder particles are electrostatically charged in a gun and they are sprayed with this gun. So due to this, the powder wraps and sticks to the base part. To obtain solid tough abrasion resistant coating, the powder coated item are placed in oven and then heated to about 160 to 210 degrees Celsius, and depending on the type of the powder used, depending on the ingredients added. Then at last, under the action of this heat, what happens? The powder melts, flows and forms a gel around the base article. And in case of thermosetting polymers, there will be cross-linking. Cross-linking is a special characteristic of thermosets. So once the cross-linking takes place, this type of coating cannot be remelted, cannot be reused. Whereas for thermoplastics, there is no cross-linking, therefore the coating can be melted again, remelted and recoated. So the coatings can be of highly glossy, or they can be having matte finish, glossy or matte finish. This is the diagrammatic representation of how the spraying gun sprays the negatively charged the powder particles on this base, grounded base article, and this base article after curing gets the coating of powder, polymer powder. So this is the actual picture of spraying the powder on the article. Next method is fluidized bed method. So actually in this method, the base metal is cleaned and then it is dipped in a fluidized bed, fluidized aerated bed of polymer powder. The article, base article, can be either heated or it may not be heated before dipping, before immersing it into the fluidized bed. So after cleaning, the base is lowered into fluidized and aerated bed of polymer. Due to that, what happens? The powder sticks to the hot base surface, or sometimes it may not be hot base surface, and then forms a film. To obtain the final solid abrasion resistant coating, again final curing is done in an oven by heating it in an oven at 160 to 210 degrees Celsius. So this is how fluidized bed method, this diagrammatic representation, actual picture showing the base article like racks, dishwasher racks or refrigerator racks dipped into the polymer powder, aerated fluidized powder. Then the third method is plasma spraying method. In this method, again the polymer base article is cleaned and made rough. The fine powder particles are introduced into a high velocity plasma flame. So this is the difference. Polymer, when enters the high velocity plasma flame moving towards the base, the powder melts in this heat of flame, and then along it is carried along with the velocity of the flame. The flame is towards the base and therefore it sticks to the base part and forms the film. So the figure is shown in the next slide. To obtain a solid abrasion resistant coating, again it is finally cured at 160 to 210 degrees Celsius. So once again, there may be cross-linking or there may not be cross-linking depending on the polymer type used, thermoset or thermoplastic. So these are the three methods. So this is the third, plasma spraying method, diagrammatic representation and actual picture showing the plasma method. So under the action of flame, action of flame heat, high velocity, the powder particles initially dry, they will become, they will melt and then they are moving or they are flowing towards the base, and then they stick here. So this is the molten particle shown here. There are some advantages of these powder coating method. It gives protection from corrosion, and one of the best advantage of this method is there are no VOCs generated, that is volatile organic compounds generated in this method. The coating is hard and durable until and unless it is scratched with a metal. We can have unlimited color, any desired color we can give, and either we can have highly glossy to matte finishes, that is finish choices are also there. Then we can add the ingredients as per the requirement. Then we can have wide range of thickness, very thin to thick coatings can be given, and less hazardous waste is generated by this method, and the investment is also less. The ore spray can be recycled provided it is of one color. The disadvantages of this method, the powder coating method, are on small scale the cost of powder coating is higher than spray painting. This should be done in the, this indicates that it should be done in the large scale. And powder coating will break down when exposed to UV rays after 5 to 10 years. And then it gets peeled off quickly or get scratched. So these are the disadvantages of powder coating. And there are many applications of powder coating. There are wide applications, from furnitures to construction to houseware. Most famous is non-stick cookware. Then automobile parts, especially the wheel rims, bicycle frames, JCB and truck bodies are coated with these shock absorbers, are also coated with powder. Then garden equipments, toys, sports equipments. So there are many applications of powder coating. So we can see the pictures of powder coating, the safety helmets, non-stick cookware, furnitures, wheel rims, then stairs, railings, bodies of automobiles, then cycles. There are different applications. The basketball rim. These are the wide uses of powder coating. There are many other applications. So these are the few which are shown here. Thank you.